Now, all month long, we've been celebrating 60 years of WREG by asking some of your favorite former News Channel 3 personalities, where are they now?
And it turns out two of them are still a team, not on the air, but in life. Pam Crittendon Roberson and Doug Johnson join us this morning. Hey, guys, welcome back home. Good to see you.
Thank you. It's so great to be here. I'm trying to sit so I'm skinny.
You got it working right there, Pam.
Yeah, okay.
You
got it working.
When was the last time you were here?
We were just talking. I think the last time I was actually in this building was in 97.
Unbelievable.
I know.
Girlfriend, you need to get downtown.
I know. Well, you know, y'all wouldn't let me in.
Don't say it.
And you've just had your 15th anniversary at FedEx.
15 years at FedEx this month, yes.
A company almost as big as Channel 3.
And Doug, what about you last time you were here?
I was just here. I was dropping something off at the front desk a couple of years ago.
So we didn't let you in the back?
No, barely let me in the front, but I lived around the corner for about 5 or 6 years, so I've been in the neighborhood.
When did you leave here?
I left a year after she did. I left in 98 to move to Nashville.
And he's still following you.
Well, it just so happened that way.
I came back for her.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, you came back to Memphis for her.
Yes.
Actually, he really did. I recruited him. I was a manager at FedEx looking for a producer, and he was working at CNN at the time. I said, hey, why don't you come work at FedEx? And he said, okay. So I was his boss for a little while.
You enjoyed that, didn't you, Pam?
I was not going to say it, but we worked together at FedEx for a little bit. But it was good. Oh my God, you got that striped dress.
Yeah, what was that dress about?
I'm like, what was I thinking? That was, oh good Lord.
Oh, I like that hair. That's a good, oh, you got the tie working.
I could have a whole, you know, photo album of different hairstyles.
Yeah. I've got a shelf at the house.
There's Jerry Tate and Pam back in the day. That was some kind of dressy news.
From your standpoint, you were our medical reporter at that time. Were there any stories in particular that really stood out for you?
You know, you do so many, but I covered Cynthia Salinas when she was at St. Jude. She's actually working at St. Jude now.
Cool.
And I had the opportunity in my current job to do an update on her a year or so ago. I mean, it's just fascinating to see what she had come through, you know, with her cancer treatment when she was a small child, and then losing a large portion of her family, but working through that. And like so many kids who end up being treated at St. Jude, they turn around and want to do the same thing for other kids, which is just amazing.
Great story. Talk about a where are they now.
Yeah, that's very true. Nice girl.
You know what people are wondering. So when did the romance start?
Let's say it started after I left FedEx.
So you were no longer her employee.
It didn't start here.
We were always friends, you know. Right. We got along with buddy and all that. But as far as when he started working at FedEx, we spent a little more time together, got to know each other. But then you know, I was his boss, so it was, you know, let's just be civil. So
I was only ever civil with any of my bosses here. So that was the same kind of thing. But
then after he left, maybe there's something more there.
There you go. And it worked out well because neither of us were married by that point anymore.
Well, that's helpful.
That is helpful.
Who asked out first?
The boss.
I didn't.
Oh, really?
Yes. No.
Was it me?
Yes.
Okay. Well, maybe it was me.
You know what that shows?
What?
Doug's got it working like that. When the boss asks you out, you know you got it together.
That's very
true. Guys, it's good to have you both back.
Well, it is great to be back. Good to see you.
Good to see you guys.
It's wonderful memories coming back.
Yeah. All right.
Now, we'll see you in another 20 years.
Hopefully. I'll bring my walker up here.